An ArrayList collects objects. We call those objects the elements of the list. Here's one way of thinking about an ArrayList. You can think of it as a sequence of mailboxes. Here is how you get an element out of an ArrayList. Remember that gallery was an ArrayList of pictures. The get method can get a picture out of that collection. The argument of the get method is called an index. And as it happens in Java, the index values start with 0. So the first element is at position 0. The second element is at position 1. The third at position 2, and so on. The get method returns the element stored at the index position. In our case, that's the initial element. And we store that in this variable. What if we wanted to get at the last element? Then we need to know how many elements are stored in the ArrayList at this time. The size method tells us that. So gallery.size is the number of elements that's currently stored in this particular ArrayList. Since the first index is 0, the last index is 1 less than the size. Look at over here. This list here has length 5, and the last element has index 4. Now, once we have the last index, we can again use the get method, passing it the last index, to get the last element out of here. Here you've seen how to access elements individually. More often than not, you actually want to access all of the elements in a loop. So let's have a look at that. In order to work with every element in an ArrayList, you want to call the get method for every valid index. That means 0, 1, 2, and so on, up to the size minus 1. So here's what we need to put into our for loop. I starts at 0. It gets incremented at every step. And we stay in the loop while I is less than the size of the ArrayList. So this is the classic loop to traverse all of the elements in an ArrayList. I takes every legal index value. For each I, we get the element stored in the ArrayList. And then we do something with that element. You'll get to try that right now. Go ahead and write a loop that draws every picture in the gallery.